My name is Dr. Michael Williams. I'm a consultant clinical oncologist and I work at Addenbrooke's Hospital in Cambridge. If I was a patient who'd been referred for radiotherapy, the things that I would want to ask my doctor would be, first of all, things about the illness itself, the disease, its extent, and whether or not it's curable with treatment. I would then want to know details about the radiotherapy treatment itself and the procedures involved. And then I think the next thing would be the side effects, both in the short term and long term, and overall the chance of success and what the aims of treatment are. Radiotherapy is a treatment with radiation, and the radiation is produced from an X-ray machine, comes out as a beam that can be neither seen nor felt. It's quite painless to have and is able to damage cancer cells, although it also damages normal cells, but the normal cells can recover from the injury much better, whereas the cancer cells go on and die. So it has a high success rate in treating cancer in the area that it's shone at. The radiotherapy process starts with an appointment to see the consultant, who will discuss the disease that's going to be treated, what the outlook is, and will outline the next steps and the side effects from radiotherapy. And this usually involves a patient having a full explanation and signing consent. Courses of treatment depend on what the intention is. For palliative treatment, which is to relieve symptoms in patients who have an incurable disease, it may be a short course of treatment over a week or even a single attendance. For radical treatment, which aims to cure the patient, it will usually go on for 4 to 6 or 7 weeks. This will involve attending every day, and the patient will be in the room on the treatment machine for about 10 minutes. The beam is usually on for a small proportion of that, so each field, which there may be 3 or 4 fields, will be on for about a minute. And at that point, all the staff leave the room so that they don't get irradiated. The beam comes on, there's a little bit of a whirring and buzzing. The patient doesn't feel anything, then the staff come back in and set up the next treatment field. Radiotherapy treatment itself doesn't hurt. You can't tell when it's on in terms of sensation. You can hear the machine making a whirring noise, but you don't feel anything at the time. But it may be unpleasant in that it produces side effects. Patients can feel sick afterwards, so they're given anti-sickness drugs. And depending what part of the body is being treated, there will be other side effects during treatment, possibly sore skin, possibly diarrhea, and those would have to be discussed with your consultant before treatment. The long-term risks vary, and you would need a detailed conversation with your consultant about what the hazards are. One of the important hazards for all patients is the risk that radiotherapy may induce a second cancer. That is rare, but an important complication which should be discussed with the patient. Whether or not radiotherapy is given in combination would depend on the disease that's being treated. For some cancers, such as head and neck cancer, it can be the only treatment and then replaces surgery. For other diseases, such as breast cancer, it's used in combination with surgery so that the main lump is removed by surgery and then radiotherapy follows. And for other diseases which are sensitive to chemotherapy, such as lymphoma, chemotherapy is given first and then radiotherapy is used to consolidate at the end. People you'd expect to meet are, first of all, the doctor who is the clinical oncologist or radiotherapist in charge of your treatment. The other people involved would be radiographers who would actually use the scanning machine, which is part of planning your treatment, and they would deliver your treatment on a daily basis. Then there is a third group, which are the physicists who measure the output from the machine and do all the calculations to do with producing the plan, which is individualized for you of how long the machine has to be on in order to give the correct dose. Radiotherapy is one of the main ways in which we can cure cancer. It comes second only to surgery and contributes to curing just under half of patients who are cured of their cancer.